Now let's summarize what we've studied in this lesson. In the first part of this lesson, An Historical Perspective, we saw how Western man's unique scientific view of lightning and the effects of rubbed amber and other substances led the way to the discovery of the secrets of electricity itself. In 1752, lightning was shown to be a form of electricity. In the 1780s, the basic mathematical laws of electricity were discovered. In 1800, the first battery was created. And in 1897, the electron itself was discovered. In less than a century and a half, electricity had emerged as a science that would then lead to the impressive technological achievements of our modern world. In the second portion of this lesson, Electricity and Atomic Theory, we saw how electricity is based on the structure of the atom itself, and most especially on the valence electrons of the atom. Electrons are attracted toward protons, and conversely, electrons are repelled from other electrons, while protons are repelled from other protons. If the valence shell of an atom has one electron, it typically is able to give up that electron easily, which causes the material to be a good electrical conductor. Finally, in the third segment, Electrostatics, we explored the fundamental principle of electricity, Coulomb's law, which states that like charges repel and unlike charges attract. If a material gains electrons, a negative charge will result. An atom that has gained an electron is called a negative ion. An atom is called a positive ion if it loses an electron and will tend to attract electrons back to rebalance the atomic structure. In the next lesson, we will study the four basic factors that make up electricity: current, voltage, resistance, and power.